the Mobile Crusher. That is our BR380, and we're going to bring this baby onto our demo area now. It is being operated by a remote control, which you'll see just on the big screen here now, by our operator, Peter. And Peter, as you can see, can multitask. He can operate the PC290 as well as bring in the BR380 via the remote control. What we see here is Komatsu's first 0-2 machine in Europe. And you may ask yourself, how is that possible? Very easy. Komatsu purchases the equivalent of CO2 produced by the machine every year for the lifetime of the machine. It is a self-propelled machine that feeds material into the jaw crusher via the vibrating hopper and then crushes it to a variable size between 50 to 400 millimeters. Now, what you will have seen here on the side is that our Lars already connected the water hose, and that is so we don't have so much dust now in the air. So I'd say let's load up this mobile crusher and see it be put to work. Come on, Peter, go for it. So the first thing you're going to see is that on the right side, the smaller fragments as well as sand are being ejected. So let's get rid of those first. And now let's go for it. So metal parts are being removed with the magnetic separator, and the separated material is being conveyed with the injection belt. We also have internal sensors at work here. So in case there is a blockage, they immediately register it and they stop the blocker if need be before any damage can occur. And this is quite spectacular actually from the shows we've done during the rest of bauma, is that, as I mentioned, we have the water connected now, so there's no dust and particles flying through the air right now. So I'd say let's wait just a moment until it's finished. Lars is gonna check right now, see how much we still have got. A little bit still in there, but I think it's looking good. Now, all the parameters for the crusher as well as the conveyor belt, they can be very easily read and checked just on the side on the input panel. And then they can be controlled on the color display, and that's what you're going to be seeing in just a few moments. Lars will be showing that to you. See, now Lars is opening up the side panel to show you. You can see the color display. Everything seems A-OK. And what Lars is also going to do, he's going to switch to manual control. As you saw a little bit earlier, Peter was using the remote control to bring it in. So let's switch it up to manual now so that Lars can use the upper drive control to park the machine. First, of course, we have to disconnect the water hose. Rainer over here waiting very patiently on the WA320, which I'll tell you about in just a few moments. Okay, next thing that Lars needs to do is he needs to make sure that the pre-screening is stowed away. And close the side panel, and then we are good to go. And there we have the crushed material, by the way, if you want to take a peek. Okay, here's our Lars coming back up. Now, if you could just park it back over there, because we need our demo area free again. Okay.